welcome to the new module of BioWorld. I am sure that you have done a good revision of the previous lessons. Am I right? Are you wondering where I am standing now? Today, I have brought some surprises for you. For that, I have a friend. Hello, will you help my students? Yes. In the previous class, we have discussed about the human endocrine system. A fabulous and magnificent system which helps to coordinate all the activities in our body through chemical messengers. Today, we are going to discuss about the chemical messengers in animals as well as in plants. Each and everything in nature are unique and marvelous. Shall we go for a nature walk? Come on, let's go. Wow, a beautiful garden. Isn't it? Look at that, a cute butterfly. Hey, look at that, honeybee, owners of honey factory. See, the ants are moving in a trial. They don't have any ears or mouth to communicate. They don't even have any mobiles or GPS for communication. But how is it possible? Even without all these modern devices, they are very smart in leading a very active social life. Hey, there's a guest. See, what a lovely cat. You might have observed certain animals marking their territory by spraying urine, don't you? For example, cats and cat family members like tigers, lions, then dog, all these do this type of marking their boundary or territory, which help them to communicate themselves. So, such organisms use a special type of chemical messengers which help them to communicate among the members of the same species is called pheromones. So children, let's study the fascinating details of pheromones.
So let's study the interesting details of pheromones. So pheromones are chemical substances that are secreted by certain animals to the surroundings to facilitate communication, and they are acting as chemical messengers to communicate among same species. So what is the basic difference between hormone and pheromone? Hormone are produced within the body, whereas pheromones are produced outside the body. Second thing is that hormones helps to communicate within the body, that means among various systems and organs, whereas pheromones helps to communicate among the different members of the same species. Now let's move on to the function of pheromone. They helps in attracting mates, helps in informing the availability of food, helps to determine the path of travel, helps to signaling dangers, helps to live in colonies. Let's have a look on some examples which widely use pheromones in their life. First example is honeybee. Bees use chemical cues to interact with each other and to manage colony organization. Pheromones are the part in communication between different members in the colony. So before going to the details of pheromones in honeybee, let's introduce the members in honeybee colony. Who lives in a colony? There are basically three types of members: kyun, worker and drawn. The kyun is the authority of the colony. Her job is to lay egg and preside over the hive. There is only one kyun in the hive. Second category is the worker. All the worker bees are females. Their role is to collect food, water and care for larvae and guard the hive. So they are the real workers. And the third member in a colony is drawn. They are basically the males in the colony. Unlike the kyun and worker, the drones do not have any stringers. So these are the three types of members in a beehive. So here you can see kyun bee, drone and worker. So pheromones are the main part in communication between kyun, worker, drone and larvae. They can sense pheromones on different ways, that is with the help of antenna, mouth and feet. They have one of the most complex pheromonal communication system found in nature, with 15 different varieties of chemicals. And very interestingly, they are the special pheromones used usually for recruiting, for nursing, for cell construction or beehive construction, for searching nectar, for marking the eggs, alarm, etc. So very effective and very efficient system of communication. Next group of organisms which widely use these type of pheromones are ants. Ants use the pheromones in a number of different ways, such as releasing danger pheromone upon death to alert nearby ants, or to create chemical trails from their nest to promising food sources. Other ants in the colony can use their antenna to detect these pheromones and respond accordingly. Next group is termites. Termites belongs to the insect family. The habitat includes soil, wood, decayed trees and leaves. Usually they are detritivores or detritivore feeding the dead plants and trees. Some of them can even feed plastic and paper. They also make use of pheromones to lead a very active and smart social life. Let's see some example from higher organism. Musk deer produce pheromone called muscon. Civet cat produce civeton. And female silkworm moth produce bombycol in order to attract its male. Moving to the next topic. Artificial pheromone. Artificial pheromones are widely used as a pest control method in agricultural field. We use pheromone traps, which is artificially synthesized pheromones are making use of in order to attract the pest so that we can control the pest to a certain extent. The next topic is chemical messengers in plants. Similar to animals, plants also produce a set of chemical messengers called plant hormones for control and coordinating life activities. They are also known as plant growth regulators. Some examples are cytokinin, gibberellin, auxin, ethylene, abscisic acid. I repeat, examples of plant growth regulators or plant hormones are cytokinin, gibberellin, auxin, ethylene and abscisic acid. Let's see the function of each plant hormone. Cytokinin, it helps in cell growth, cell division and cell differentiation. So growth means enlargement in size of the cell, Division means divide into many, and differentiation means fully able to do the function properly. So differentiation means cell after the growth and division start to do its function. So here you can see the cell divides into two with the help of the hormone cytokinin. Next one is gibberellin. Gibberellin helps to stimulate the breakdown of stored food to facilitate germination. So they basically helps to germinate the seeds and also help to sprout the leaves. So here you can see a clipping of sprouting of leaves as well as germination. So germination enhanced with the help of gibberellin. And here also you can see the sprouting of new leaves. Next hormone is auxin. Auxin helps in cell growth, cell elongation, promoting growth of terminal buds, and also helps in fruit formation. What is terminal bud? Terminal buds are the tip of the plant. Here you can see two different types of plant. One is a tree-like plant having a woody stem with a terminal bud, and the other one is coming under the category of lower plant, say for example herb or shrub, which also have a tip called a terminal bud. So what is terminal bud? That is the tip of the plant. So auxin helps in fruit formation too, along with cell elongation and cell growth. Next one is ethylene. Ethylene helps in ripening of leaves as well as fruits. Excess release causes dropping of leaves and fruits. So here you can see the change in color when the fruit ripens. Initially it is green in color, slowly it turns to yellow, and when they ripen they become pure yellow. So ethylene helps in ripening of leaves as well as fruits. Here also you can see the various stages of ripening of a fruit. Next one is abscisic acid. Abscisic acid is a phytohormone, helps in dropping of ripened leaves and fruits. It also helps in dormancy of embryo. What is dormancy? Dormancy is the inactive stage, and embryo is seen inside the seed. So we use certain cereals, pulses in our daily diet, that is actually the inactive form of embryo. So what happens when these seeds are soaked in water? They start to germinate. So what happens when it is in dried form? Abscisic acid is active in dried form of seed so that it prevents germination and enhance the dormancy state. And when we soak it in water, abscisic acid's activity will be inhibited and the gibberellin get activated, which enhancing germination. So here you can see the various stages of coconut fruit. The green color indicates the not much ripened one. The yellow indicates the ripened, and the last brown color or the dark color shade indicates the dormant stage of the seed. Some plants and trees also show dormancy in their life stage. For example, during unfavorable conditions, they shed their leaf. It is also an example of dormancy state. When they face extreme cold or drought, they usually shed their leaf and they become inactive. Now let's move on to artificial plant hormones. By identifying the chemical structure of hormones, artificial hormones are developed, which has contributed drastic progress in agricultural sector. For example, changes in fruit size, shape and color, gardening innovations, increases production, seedless fruits, synchronized harvesting. Synchronized means at the same time, harvesting at the same time. Weed control, that means removing unwanted plants from the field. Sprouting of roots, preventing ripening and sprouting. Now let's have a detailed look of artificial hormone. First of all, artificial auxins. Seedless orange, grapes, watermelon can be produced with the help of artificial auxin. So seedless watermelon usually have many seeds. So nowadays with the help of this auxin, we can produce seedless watermelon. Similarly, seedless grapes are also familiar to you, which is produced with the help of auxin. Seedless oranges are producing with the help of this artificial auxin. Apart from producing seedless fruits, auxins are also used for sprouting roots. For example, naphthalene acetic acid and indole butyric acid. So NAA and IBA are some examples of artificial auxins which help to produce roots in the stem. So usually we use these type of artificial hormones in stem cutting plants, which stimulate the root formation in the stem. Next one is application. So auxins are widely used as weedicide. Weedicide means to destroy weeds, unwanted plants in the field. For sprouting of roots, prevent dropping of premature fruits to produce seedless fruits. So these are some of the application of artificial auxins. Next one, gibberellin. Gibberellin promotes parthenocarpy. What is parthenocarpy? Development of fruit without fertilization. So such fruits, they don't have any seed at all. One example for parthenocarpy is banana. When we cut open the banana, there is no seed, but instead there are small blackish spot inside. Actually, the seeds are not formed. Why? Because there is no fertilization. So fertilization, without fertilization, the fruit is forming. That process is known as parthenocarpy. So it promotes parthenocarpy, again helps in seedless fruit formation. Used for increasing fruit size in grapes and apples, preventing ripening of fruit to assist marketing. So what are the functions of gibberellin? Promotes in parthenocarpy, used for increasing fruit size in grapes and apple, preventing ripening of fruits to assist marketing. Next one is ethylene. Ethylene is used for flowering of plants at a time, for example pineapple, so that the farmers can do the harvest in the same time. It also helps in ripening of fruits, for example lemon, orange, tomato, etc. An artificial ethylene known as ethaphone is used in rubber trees to increase the production of latex. Usually ethylene is a gaseous plant hormone, but ethaphone is artificially synthesized liquid form of ethylene, which is used in rubber trees to increase the production of latex. So in pineapple farms and in rubber plantation, we widely use the artificial ethylene. Next one is abscisic acid. Abscisic acid is used for harvesting fruits at the same time. So the process of harvesting can be done with the help of wide use of abscisic acid. So fruits can be harvested in the same time from all the plants with the help of spraying the abscisic acid. Now let's see the impact of artificial plant hormones. So all the artificial plant hormones are synthesized artificially. So excessive or wide use or uncontrolled use of this may lead to serious health and environmental issues. So excess use of these artificial hormones may lead to health issues. For example, cancer, allergy, gastric disorders, nervous disorders are also accompanied with this artificial plant hormone. They also cause environmental issues in the sense they changes the natural property of the plants and the environment. So when we use the pheromone trap and all, the colony of the insects will acquire certain type of adaptations which cause resistance. So environmental issues and health issues may occur if you use these artificial plant hormones in an excess way. So always have a limit for all these chemical substances.
Hope you have enjoyed the session. Please go through the slides very well. So here I am concluding. Thank you.